This is how to determine a bomb calorimeter heat capacity. What is the heat capacity of a bomb calorimeter if the combustion of 5.25 millimoles of diethyl ether in the gas phase, and we're given the enthalpy of combustion, increases the temperature of the calorimeter by 3.517 degrees Celsius? Okay, if we knew how much heat the calorimeter was experiencing, we know that is equal to the heat capacity of the calorimeter times the temperature change. So we know the temperature change. The heat capacity is what we're trying to solve for, and we have to figure out Q calorimeter. So I will fill in my 3.517 degrees Celsius, and all I need to finish this equation is to figure out the heat change of the calorimeter. Okay, the heat change of the calorimeter is actually going to be equal to the negative heat of constant volume of the reaction that we're doing in the calorimeter, okay, which you may also know as the negative energy change of the reaction. All right, the energy change of the reaction is going to be equal to the heat at constant pressure plus the work, and you know heat of at constant pressure as delta H and work. Okay, I think we can get heat at constant pressure pretty easily. We're given 0.00525 moles, so I've just converted my millimoles to moles, and I'm also given the enthalpy of combustion, so that's minus 3025 kilojoules per mole. Now I just have to figure out work, which means I need the change in moles of gas. So I guess I better write the reaction out. C4H10O in the gas phase. I'm going to burn it with oxygen to make CO2 and water. Okay, 4 CO2s. 5 waters, and it looks like 6 oxygens. Okay, delta NG is going to be equal to my 4 moles of CO2 minus my 7 moles of gas on the other side, so that's going to be minus 3. So my work is going to be minus delta NG RT. So it's going to be equal to my minus 3 times how many moles I have in the reaction. It's minus 3 moles of gas per 1 mole of diethyl ether, but I don't have 1 mole. I have 0.00525 moles of diethyl ether. And I will also multiply that by R. I'm going to keep my R in kilojoules, 0.008314, and that'll be in kilojoules per Kelvin mole. And I'm doing this at 298K. Okay. And that value is a very tiny correction at 0.3902 kilojoules. So I will move my work back up here. That's going to be plus 0.03902 kilojoules. And I still have to multiply this out to figure out my delta H. And when I multiply this out and add the work, it turns out that my delta H and my delta and my work add up to minus 15.842 kilojoules. So this is my energy change for my reaction, and Q calorimeter is actually going to be equal to the opposite sign of the energy change. So I will take this value and I will sub it in out here, up here, 15.842 kilojoules. Okay, well, now I just have to divide it by the temperature. So my heat capacity is going to be equal to 15.842 kilojoules divided by 3.517 degrees Celsius. And that turns out to be 4.504, and it's units of kilojoules per degree Celsius, which are very lovely heat capacity units. All right, that's it.